Good morning, dear students. Let's start with the new chapter, Vaikam Satyagraha, Struggle Against Untouchability, written by K.N. Panikkar. I hope you have all watched the video I have posted in the classroom. What is untouchability? It is a practice that has prevailed in India, that is outcasting a group of people basis of the caste. They were regarded as untouchables. The lower caste people were segregated from other people. They were denied of basic civil rights. There were so many evil practices related to this untouchability. Let's know about the author K.N. Panikkar. He is the leftist. He is the Indian historian associated with the Marxist school of historiography. He is actively participated in criticizing the rise of the nationalist history of India. He is a great inspiration for academicians as well as activists throughout this country. What is Vaikam Satyagraha and how was it started? What is the impact of it? These are the points that were discussed in this essay. How is it started? It started. Vaikam Satyagraha was started on a fine morning, dated on 30th March 1924, and started by three men, Kunyapi, Bahuleyan and Govinda Panikkar. They were walking on the road, hand in hand. The road is that leads to Shiva Temple at Vaikam. And the road is forbidden for the polluting caste. What are these polluting castes? They were the lower caste people. There were policemen patrolling that area, and the three men were stopped by this policeman at the notice board. What is it written in the notice board? Iravas and other low castes are prohibited through this road. That is, the lower castes were not allowed to walk on that road. The policemen asked the caste of their three men. The three men declared their caste. Kunyapi from Pulaya caste, Bahuleya from Iyava caste and Govinda Panikkar from Nayak caste. Only Govinda Panikkar is allowed to travel on that road. The other two, Bahuleya and Kunyapi, were denied to enter the premises. But the three men were strong and were firm on their decision. They walked on their road. But they were promptly arrested and they got punished for 6 months imprisonment. The arrest did not weaken the protesters. Instead, the protesters' numbers were increasing day by day. And this is the starting of Vaikam Satyagraha. It is the first ever organized movement in Kerala for the eradication of untouchability and unapproachability. Vaikam Satyagraha is a social reform movement happened in Kerala from the last quarter of the 19th century. At the same time, there is national movement, that is, they are struggling for the liberation of India from British clutches. So the Vaikam Satyagraha helped the national movements to draw its political and social perspectives and the methods and the principles that they have adopted in the Vaikam Satyagraha. In turn, the national movement had also lent support and leadership in the Vaikam Satyagraha. And the Vaikam Satyagraha became the good example for the mutual relation between the local and national movements during the liberation struggle, that is the struggle for freedom. The embarrassing treatments practiced in the name of caste as distancing the lower caste people and regarding them as pollutants, excluding from the public places of worship and denying the civic rights enjoyed by the upper caste. And the people who are from lower caste do not have access to any public roads near temples. They cannot be appointed for the government jobs, and their children could not be admitted to the government schools. In this context, T.K. Madhavan, who is the original architect of the Vikram Satyagraha, he is the Indian social reformer who led the struggle against untouchability. At first, T.K. Madhavan moved a resolution in the assembly of 1989 declaring temple entry is my birthright. But it was not allowed by Diwan, as he is pointing that it is a religious issue and it will create disagreement in the society. But T.K. Madhavan is not willing to take back the rejection of the resolution by the Diwan. Inspired him to take this cause to a higher level. As a first step, what is the first step to this direction? He met Gandhiji at Tirunelveli in 1923 to seek Gandhiji's advice and support for launching an agitation for temple entry. Agitation means prakshobam. Gandhiji had already approved the agitation and suggested civil disobedience and non-violent satyagraha. Gandhiji stated that you should use only civil disobedience movement and non-violence as the forms of struggle. Don't use violence. And he also gave message to the people of Travancore. Gandhiji gave message to the people of Travancore that untouchables has the right to worship in Hindu temples. Gandhiji emphasized that every man, every untouchable, his untouchable or touchable, everyone has the right to worship in the Hindu temples. Gandhiji's appeal had played an important role in enlightening the upper caste people. Many of the upper caste people had favored this temple entry. So many upper caste people formed associations and they fought against. Many of the upper caste people formed many associations and fought against the discrimination against the lower caste. The Kerala Hindu Sabha, the Naya Service Society, the Yogakshema Sabha and Kathriya Sabha, all these upper caste associations supported the temple entry and they demanded for the temple entry, and some of these associations have campaigned for the same reason. After taking support of Gandhiji, T.K. Madhavan's next step is to establish the links with national movement. In order to establish those closer links, he became a member of Indian National Congress and participated in the Kakinada session of 1923. And it is presided by Maulana Muhammad Ali. He participated as a delegate in order to attract their attention to the situation of Travancore. That Travancore situation is the untouchabilities that prevailing in Travancore. He immediately, Travancore means it is now Kerala. Before independence, the state is called Travancore. Okay, there are many divisions. T.K. Madhavan was successful in this mission. How it is evident? It is clear that he got an invitation from the Congress to attend the working committee of the Congress so that he can introduce the resolution for the formation of All India Committee. There now it is spreading all over India to eradicate the untouchability prevailing all over India. So we can see that T.K. Madhavan is step by step, he is very actively participating to eradicate the, to erase this practice called so-called practice untouchability. After the Kakinada's firm decision, the Kerala Provincial Congress Committee formed a committee that is anti-untouchability, which is against untouchability, and the convener of this committee is K. Kelappan, and other members includes T.K. Madhavan, Kurur Neelakandan Nambudiri Padi, T.R. Krishnaswamy Iyer and K. Velayudhan Menon. The committee announced a decision. What is the decision? They want to inaugurate a program at Vikram on 1st March 1924. It is dated on 1st March by leading, and they want to lead a rally. Procession means rally, consisting of the all members of the society, not only
Touchables, untouchables, everyone is included in this rally, and they want to walk on this prohibited roads for the roads prohibited for the untouchables around the temple. This announcement had made lots of disturbance in this orthodox sections of the society. What is this orthodox? They were not ready to change. They were firmly believing their old beliefs. And the local officials feared there will be the peace will be broke, the peace will be disturbed in the society. So the local officials insisted this committee to not to conduct this program. So the Satyagraha leaders agreed, they have agreed to postpone this procession, that is rally, to March 30th. First they have planned on 1st March and it is postponed to 30th March. As expected, the Satyagraha has brought more enthusiasm at the local and the national level. Volunteers came from all over Kerala and the number was very, very large. And in order to control these volunteers upcoming, the organizers had to put the public appeal to volunteers. What is that public appeal? They want these volunteers had to reach Vaikom only after the prior permission, and they want to get a certificate of character. The certificate should be from some important citizen. Then the political life in Kerala becomes suddenly alive. Everyone is enthusiastically participating in this Satyagraha. The Satyagraha, this Vaikom Satyagraha, became the symbol not only for the struggle from untouchability and caste oppression, but also the nationalist thirst for freedom from the social and political bonds, freedom from British. This struggle is viewed as the part of struggle at the national level. The active involvement of Sri Narayana Guru has also gave good inspiration and guidance for the Satyagrahis. The Sri Narayana Guru's words were taken as such in this essay. The will to suffer and sacrifice should be there, but there is no need of getting wet or starved or getting hungry during the process. Enter everywhere the places that have banned and face the consequence, face the result. You may be get beaten, but don't beat back. You may get blows from the police, but don't blows back. If your fence is raised in your path, if you're going and if the fence is raised, don't turn back, jump over it. Don't stop with walking through the road, enter the temple. So don't stop only for the road, enter the temple, every temple, every day, everybody, everyone should enter every temple, not only roads, but also enter the temple. If the offering of rice is ready, in temples we will get offerings, right? If the offering was ready, go and take it. Go to the place where free food is served and sit with those touchables. Let the government should also be informed about this movement. What is the intention of this movement? Government should be informed of your intentions. One should not fight shy of lying down one's life. Do not lie one's life under the feet of others. Those who think another's touch pollutes him, go and touch him. Go and pollute him by touching him. But there should not be any violence. There should not be any force. Don't be perturbed by coercion. Don't use force to change the normal path. It will take time. So, Swamiji says that don't use any force or threats to change their paths. Guru not only visited the places of the Satyagraha, but also presided many public meetings held at the venue. Gandhiji also visited Guru at Shivagiri. After the Guruji's visit at the Satyagraha's venue, Gandhiji had visited Guru, and the conversation between these two great personalities, we can see some extract from this conversation. Gandhiji asks, "Is there any difference of opinion for Swamiji about the Satyagraha started at Vaikom?" Gandhiji asks, "Is there any difference in the Satyagraha started at Vaikom? Does Swamiji think of adding or altering anything to the movement?" Gandhiji asks, "Swamiji has a different opinion about this movement?" Guruji answers, "My knowledge is that it is going very smoothly. There is no violence. It is going very smoothly. And I do not think of any alterations. I do not want to bring any difference, any changes in this movement." Gandhiji replied, "Some are of the opinion that non-violent satyagraha is of no use, and to establish right, violence is necessary." What is Swamiji's opinion? Gandhiji says that there were some opinion rising that non-violence is of no use. To get rights, you want to use violence. Through violence, you can achieve your rights. What he asked, Gandhiji asked, what is the Swamiji's opinion? Guruji replies that, while I think, he also thinks that violence is not good. Only non-violence is very good for this movement. Fine, children. I think you understand this topic of untouchability and the struggles T.K. Madhavan had took for this movement. So I hope I conclude this session today. Tomorrow we can conclude this essay. We can complete this essay. Thank you very much.